welcome to my channel, Jill Ling Yi. This channel is about sharing of ghost stories, artwork ideas, craft works using epoxy resin, kalimba music, and tutorials for different purposes. Your support is important to me. If you enjoy my video, please help me to like, subscribe, and comment after watching. Thank you! Hello! Today we're going to talk about how to add variations to your Shopee product listing. So, first step, let us go to your seller center. When you're here, look for add new product. Give your product a name. And then choose a category for your Shopee product. Please note the name cannot be too short, so I'm going to add for teenager, male and female. After you select the category, we click next. When you are here, key in your product description. You can put in information such as size, feature, how many compartments of your backpack have, what kind of material it made of, or any keyword that it can help your buyer find your product. And then choose the brand and material. We go a little bit faster here because this step we have been through in our earlier video. Okay, so this is the part that we are going to focus today. So click enable variations. So for the first variation, give it a name. So I put size, and then I give options S, M, L because that's a quite common option when we talk about size. For you, you can just put anything. If for example, maybe like my second variation, I put color. Then I put red, pink, blue, and then maybe the third one I give it a pink. So you can add up to 20 options. So you can be creative when you're creating the variations. After that, we input the selling price. There's two ways. First, you can just key in the selling price at the main column and then click apply to all, and then everything will be the same. Or another alternative is you can put in the selling price and the unit, the stock number one by one, like what I'm doing now. I put it for $29.90 for size S, and then $39.90 for M, and maybe $49.90 is for L. And then stock also you can choose to amend one by one. If you have different stock number, I just simply put in a number so that later we can see the difference. Okay. After this step, then the next step is actually the same. Input the product images. You can add your watermark first before you actually posted the photos here. For photos, you can add up to 8 photos. So I just put 3 as a sample. And then for your variation, SML, you can put a photo. It helps your buyer understand what they are buying. I do not have a photo for size S, so I just put in a gift photo, free gift photo as a sample. Okay, after the images is inserted, then we can proceed to insert your product weight here. And then select what are the shipping methods and what fees that you want to charge to your buyer. To enable or disable the shipping option, you can just click at the green button. And if you want to amend the shipping fees, you just click at the edit icon and key in the fees that you want to charge to your buyer. I'm just joking, I'm not going to charge 1,000 ringgit. Okay, so when we're settled here, check at the last column whether this is a pre-order listing or no. Condition is a new one, and then we save and publish. So it's as simple as that. And you can see now we have the listing ready. Let's go and see the result together. So this is the listing page. This is the title we have inserted. This is the minimum selling price to the maximum selling price. And let's try and click the size and the color and see what happens. So you can see if you click L, the quantity will become 3 pieces available for different colors. This is why we set different figures earlier, so you can see the differences. And these are the photos that we inserted earlier, and the product description is here. So now your buyer can start ordering from you. Watching my video. I hope you enjoy this tutorial. If you like my video, please help to click like, subscribe, and share.